On Saturday, 2nd of December 1854, almost 1,000 miners gathered in the stockade they'd built at the Eureka Diggings at Ballarat. They had chosen Peter Lawler to be their leader, and their womenfolk had sewn a beautiful flag of blue and white. The miners took a solemn oath of allegiance to the flag, saying, "We swear by the Southern Cross to stand truly by each other and defend our rights and liberties." Back in October, a digger named Scobie had been kicked to death near the Eureka Hotel. Bentley the publican was charged with a murder, but he was friendly with the police and the charges were dropped. As a result, the Eureka Hotel was burnt to the ground, and the government sent extra soldiers from Melbourne. Three men were arrested and frequent license inspections were ordered. By the end of that hot November, tensions were at breaking point. At 4 a.m. on Sunday morning, December 3rd, 1854, most of the miners had left the stockade, and only 155 stayed there with Peter Lawler. Thinking there would be no trouble on the Sabbath day, Captain Thomas, with a well-armed force of 300 soldiers, cavalry and police, quickly overwhelmed the stockade. 30 miners were killed by gunfire or died at the point of the bayonet. 125 were taken prisoner. Peter Lawler was badly wounded and left for dead, but his sympathisers helped him to escape. He had lost his arm in the rebellion but was soon to become a respected member of a new parliament. The miners had lost the battle but won the fight. No jury would convict them. Gold licences were abolished and many police were sacked. The Eureka Stockade may well be regarded as the birthplace of Australian democracy.